Thank you very much. Yeah, as Astro mentioned, I'm not going to talk about what we work on, but I'll just give you a brief background. Our company is designing crops for new purposes. And as a simple example, we're using synthetic biology tools to make plants that make fuels directly. So instead of squeezing out sugary juice like you do today with sugarcane, we can actually get biodiesel right out of a plant. So things like that are real game changers. But when Astro came to me and said, you know, this meeting is going to happen, and think big and think where you could have an enormous impact, what really came to me is we need to improve agricultural productivity worldwide on a global basis. And, you know, it's very easy to say this is a huge, huge issue across the world, affects many, many people. The World Bank puts the value of food production at about 10% of the global GDP. But if you think about the broader impact, transportation, retail, huge number of industries, it's clear that this is one of the foundations of our economy globally. We heard yesterday about the impact on the well-being of people. About 2 billion people are chronically malnourished, chronically underfed. So doing better would have a huge and profound impact. And what I wanted to do was think about something that we could do now. You know, I've spent the last 20 years really thinking about new technology and how it can impact this space. And I think that works really well. The people in the room, we all think about technology. But one of the hard lessons I've learned about agriculture is getting technology disseminated, you know, down to the grassroots, if you will, is very, very tough if you're doing that from the top down. And what you really need to do is get people involved in it to pull that information in and to pull those changes in. So how can we have a big impact, improve agriculture, and actually have these improvements be adopted? So that's what I want to put to you. And as Astra said, this is not something I'm working on directly. We are not a company of people who are software engineers and do the kinds of things that people in this room do very well. But I just wanted to present you with a problem, hopefully inspire you to do it. I think it's pretty simple. I bet it's not as simple as I think, but I do know it's very doable. So first of all, I want to start with what is important about agricultural productivity? What makes things be productive? And what it boils down to is the decision-making of millions and millions of individual farmers all around the world. I grew up in a farming family. A number of our employees are farmers. I have profound respect for people who every single year figure out how to get a crop. And if you think about how that career works, in a lifetime, a person has about 50 shots on goal. They get 50 decisions to make. If they miss once, it's probably survivable. Twice, it's bad. Three times, you're done. You know, that's the game they're playing. And that is a really tough game. And yet people do it every single year and make it. So the big decision starts with, what do I plant? Typically in the US, people deal with hedging. They plant different crops. They look at markets. They look at environmental impact. They get the conventional wisdom. The way this decision making works is you go to the coffee shop, you talk to your neighbor, you look at the trade association. What are you going to do? Do we think corn will be expensive next year? What's soybean looking like? And somehow or other, decisions made. And then the second part is executing. Once you decide what you're planting, then how do you grow it? Do you fertilize? Do you water? Do you treat for insects? When do you plant? When do you harvest? All of those things have a huge impact as well. And small things really matter. So I'll give you a concrete example. For example, our company manufactures seed. We manufacture seed for a crop that grows in minimal water. And we do this every year in Texas. And it turns out that all the big companies in the world manufacture that same crop seed in that same region in Texas. And this year, as you've heard already, was a terrible year in Texas. When we were planning for the year, we thought there was going to be a drought. What we didn't realize, it was going to be the worst drought ever in recorded history. But we implemented some simple things to really impact productivity. For our company, we hit our targets in productivity. For the industry, the average was 20%. A fivefold difference very sophisticated companies missed. So what was the difference? We employed on the ground, in the moment, decision making with all of our farmers that had an impact. So we were measuring soil moisture content and managing the day in which we planted. We were staggering the planting, so we had a few more shots on goal. Sometimes planted crops at more of a density, so the first plant shaded the next one. And that helped preserve moisture. And, you know, some other things that we didn't plan for as well. Birds were starving this year. There was no food. They were migrating in from hundreds of miles away. We did some things to mitigate as soon as we heard about it. But next year, we're going to plant cheap stuff around our crop to make sure that we manage for those birds. And those kind of changes can happen if you get the information fast enough. So what's really needed is an amalgamation of decision-making information compiled in a way that's easy for someone to access so that you go from having 20% success to 100% success. I mean, and that could be done worldwide and would have a profound impact. So what I'd like to inspire some of you to do is collect, disseminate, prepare information, get it out to people, synthesize it in a way that works, make an interface that they can really use. And the kinds of information you'd want. Insects. Is there going to be an insect explosion 100 miles away that's going to cause insects to migrate to my region? It turns out that for every dollar you spend treating for insects, you get $4 of value back. But people don't always treat prophylactically because you don't know if you need to. Moisture, climate. What about markets? What about market shocks? So here's another example. Pakistan had a drought, it was flooding that affected cotton. Australia had a drought that affected cotton. That had an impact on cotton production here. But people didn't always have that information in real time. Or with a single stroke of a pen, China decided every child should have a half pint of milk every day. That had a global impact on the availability of calves for dairy and the availability of hay to feed those calves and the cows. So people sometimes learn about these things many, many months later, too late to really respond in real time. So what we really need to do then is get data from a lot of sources, existing databases, satellite data, and really importantly, crowdsource data, so that information comes together. And then it needs to be organized in a way so that people my father's age can tap into it and understand it with ease. And it needs to be in a simple kind of system where, you know, a smartphone-like device, where an individual anywhere in the world, a developed country, an underdeveloped country, can access that information and then act on it. And, you know, if you knew everyone south of you was planting the same thing, that would change your behavior. You know, so those simple kind of things can balance resources. The world is becoming very constrained for resources. We have to use every bit of land, all the water, in the most effective way. And we're not going to have a single person sitting in control managing allocation of resources. This is a decision that's made by millions of independent actors. And empowering those actors to make better decisions will immediately have impact. I think within a year or two, if this was available, we would start to see an uplifting of quality, production, and a balancing of resources to meet market needs in a way we'd never seen before. So that's the moonshot, Astro, and hopefully someone here would take it on. Thank you.
Let us define X. X is a solution to a seemingly insurmountable problem, like climate change or cancer, one that affects the world. But what if we redefine X as a challenge, an opportunity for radical thinking, a chance to light up the world with breakthrough ideas and cutting-edge technology, the stuff of science fiction that just might fly after all? Solving for X requires wonder and imagination and the vision to build seemingly impossible solutions to the world's biggest problems. Solve for X. Moonshot thinking.